After reports surfaced of a coral disease along just one island in Hawaii, USGS scientists decided to dive into Kauai's waters during the spring of 2015 to investigate if such things as freshwater and nutrient input may be the culprit.
So we've been out here trying to understand potential environmental drivers of coral disease on the north shore of Kauai. We've seen that there's a lot of stressors on the coral, and so it's not a simple, okay, this is the driver that causes that.
To complement the biological studies already done by their Hawaiian colleagues, USGS wanted to check water temperature, salinity, and whether water running off the land may be affecting coral health. They did some initial surveys above and below water in an undeniably picturesque setting.
I'm a microbiologist who mostly works on corals, both shallow water and deep sea. Corals, like us, are, you know, an organism that has symbiotic microbes as a critical part of its biology. So disease is when that balance between the microbes and the host gets messed up by something.
Why corals become more vulnerable to microbes is the mystery. Is it favorable conditions that encourage overgrowth of the bacteria, or unfavorable conditions that lower the coral's immunity against disease?
So we know black band is a polymicrobial disease, which means there's more than one microbe involved in causing it. There's almost always a cyanobacteria involved. In fact, that's what gives it its color. But there's also a couple different bacteria involved in the sulfur cycle, and it's that combination that causes the tissue lysis that we see as disease.
This black band clearly delineates live from dead tissues. When a disease forces coral to lose its colorful tissue, a white skeleton remains behind. This open real estate can be rapidly taken over by other algae. A bright green algae found along the shoreline can tell a different story. It's usually a sign to Peter Swarzynski that cooler groundwater may be seeping into the ocean nearby, which can carry with it fertilizers and nutrients that upset the balance of a coastal ecosystem. Finding that cooler groundwater can be done by recording ocean temperatures using a thermal infrared camera, but the team's plan to fly a helicopter along the north shore was thwarted by Kauai's raining weather. So, they were able to collect some temperature data with these small instruments.
This measures conductivity and temperature. So the idea is that these float and are going to get readings of just the surface of the ocean, the skin of the ocean.
As USGS scientists investigate the causes of this disease over the next few years, tourists will continue to flock to Kauai's oceanfront.
Because what do people want to see? They want to see vibrant reefs with healthy corals and lots of fish. If you don't have healthy corals, then you're also not going to have the same fish species, and a lot of the fish species are things that are yummy to eat. So if you don't have reefs to protect the coastline, you end up getting erosion, so you might lose the beautiful beaches, which are also important for tourism, but also for protection for people who have built houses that close to the beach.